Hey everyone, I'm Paul Krismanitz and I'm here with your Wednesday refresher. So on Sunday I was given the honor of speaking at church and I really felt that the Lord was just wanting to impart hope, just to reconstitute that value in the church. You know, at the end of 1 Corinthians 13, Paul writes about how we only see in part, but someday we're going to see fully when the perfect comes, which is when Jesus comes back. But he says, and while we wait, these three remain: faith, hope, and love. These are the things that we can still keep growing in. We are to keep going after, pursuing as a church as we mature. You know, the Bible says that hope is a sign of maturity for the believer. In Hebrews, it says that hope is our anchor. It's what we are supposed to be always returning to when the winds, the storms of the world get crazy, when life gets hard. We're always supposed to return to hope. From there, I took us into Ephesians, especially Ephesians 1, because in Ephesians, Paul writes to his most mature church. And from there, we can look at some of the deeper meats that Paul wants when he says spiritual truths can be milk or meat. We're going into meat in Ephesians. And so I felt it was important to reveal some of these deeper meat of spiritual truth, because from there, we get a whole bunch of hope. See, that's truly how good God is. When we learn more about Him, when we learn more of how He sees us, we cannot help but return to hope. He's so hopeful for us. He's so hopeful for our future. He's so hopeful for the world that we learn that and it becomes a go-to move for us. From there, we were able to step back and see, you know, when we actually stop focusing on just what's wrong here, what's wrong there, and we look back, God has actually been making all things new from the time Jesus came into the world. You know, there's a whole lot more to come, absolutely. But the world is getting better by almost every metric. And it's just amazing to live in this time, when we live in a time of technology that's just exploding everywhere, making our lives easier. Sure, there's difficulties because an abundance is a whole new problem versus lack. But it's okay because we still have a God who's in control. And if we partner with Him, we get to see all the goodness that comes from it. You know, as believers, with Jesus inside us, with Jesus walking alongside us, the Holy Spirit in us, we get to be the example to the world, the advertisement of a better life. And if we live in hope, we will have the most influence. If we live in love, we'll be the most attractive people. And we just need to stay in that place where hope abounds all the more, all the time, so that we can spread that light to the world and they will be attracted to us. A church is meant to be the most hopeful place on earth. God bless y'all. We'll see you next week.